We already talk about this of not yet.
Okay.
Okay. And then we'll go to birds. طيب. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. So we still talking about what is allowed, what is lawful, and what is not lawful of all types of food. And this is, my dear brothers, very, very important subject, because this is related to what? To our daily life, right or not? So every Muslim should know and this type of knowledge. You should know what's lawful and what's not lawful. You know, there's certain knowledge that maybe Muslim, it's not needed for everybody, because it's not applicable in his case. And certain knowledge which is applicable to everyone, therefore every Muslim should learn it. And one of these things are knowing what is the permissible food that he can consume and what is not allowed. It is very important. So we already explained the general guideline, and we said that generally speaking, everything is good in this earth to be eaten, then the Muslim can eat it. Okay? And then from this general guideline, we said there are what? Some exceptions. So, generally speaking, we said you can eat whatever you want, except. And then we, list what types of exceptions. And this, subhanAllah, a wise way. Because if we say, no, everything is not lawful, and then we'll name to you what you eat, it will be what? Unending, okay, endless list. Right or not? Everybody, I mean, every year, every country, every land, every culture, they have different types of food. So you cannot name all types. But give the general line, they said, everything is okay, except this and this and this. Okay? Right. And we reach talking about animals. What type of animals a Muslim can consume, can eat, and eat the meat, and what types it's not allowed. So we said, land animals that have hands used to pray are also prohibited. Hands like what? What type of these animals? Like what? We mentioned last week.
The one,
like?
With fun.
Like tigers?
Tigers, yes.
Okay.
Tigers,
lions.
Lions.
Dogs. Cats. All these they have hands, and they depend on the meat. They depend on meat, they eat meat. They don't eat grass. Or if you left with your cat all type of vegetables and close the door and left it for, sometimes and come back, what will happen? You'll find it what? Dead. You'll not eat all these things because looking for what? For meat. So these are type of animal who depend on meat and bread, chase games, in the wilderness. For example, you see the lions, the tigers, the fox, all these things running after other smaller animals or birds. So these are, as we said, these types of animals are forbidden. So Muslims should not use them. Right? So according to the hadith, now where's the dalil? Here's the dalil. Here's the dalil. And when we say the dalil, that means the evidence, proof, which tell you it is halal or haram. My dear brothers, this is very, very important for the Muslim. The Muslim does not depend on what people say. It's not like, Christianity, like Buddhism, like any, even Shiism. Even Shia, We don't depend on what the Sheikh said, huh? What the Bob said, what the priest said. No, we depend on what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran and what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in his hadith. Therefore, if any Sheikh, any scholar, any mufti, no matter how respected he is in his community, if he tell you to do something and there is no basis for what he commands you to do in the Quran, on the Sunnah, then you should not listen to it. This is the problem of many Muslim community. Sometimes, what they do, they just take the words of men and they follow it. And men, they misguide you. People, they may misguide you. Sometimes, people, they give an instruction that may serve their own interest or show their understanding. So here, when we say this is haram, the Sheikh to prove to you, he said, this is not my word. Take the proof, take the dalil. And this is the way of the Muslim scholars. Muslim scholars, whenever they say about something which is lawful or unlawful, or what is good or bad, all is what they do. They present to you a dalil, proof, evidence from the Quran or the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The dalil is hadith that was narrated by Abu Tha'laba Al-Khushani radiallahu anhu said, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prohibited eating any of the fan beast of prey. Very clear. Said, any. The word animals mean any animals that have this characteristic, characters should not be consumed as food or used by the Muslim. This was mentioned in Al-Bukhari and Muslim. Right. There is only one exception to this ruling. And that is the hyena. And we told, or we said this before, the hyena, some ulama, they said, it's exception from this. طيب. In this connection, Ibn Qayyim said, animals that are prohibited are those having the two attributes of having fun and being predators. They have fangs, which is sharp teeth that's coming from both sides, okay, in the front, okay, and salam. And depend on what? Depend on eating meat. That's mean always hunt other animals or birds for their diet. Let's talk about birds now. Now we know everything about animals. How about birds? Birds are generally lawful to be eating. As we said, this is what the general guideline. So here we didn't specify any type of birds. All birds are what? Lawful. All type of birds. And then comes the exception. As we said, because if we said the opposite, then how many birds will name? Endless list. Endless list. There are now, every day, all of us sometimes, they discover that there are type or kind of birds they never saw. Right or not? That we may never hear about it. You see TV, good, subhanAllah, there's bird like this, like that. I didn't know about this. SubhanAllah. So it's not to list birds. But he tell you a general guideline as food. It is all type of birth is what? Lawful. And then we come to the exception. With the exception of birds with talons used for praying. Talons used for praying and hunting animals. So any hunter among the birds who depend on meat, like falcon, like eagles, all these types of birds is what? Unlovable. In very short, if you look, what's the similarity between the animals and birds here? All they depend on what? On meat for their diet. Depend on meat. So anything would depend on meat, eating meat based on this, and they hunt for their diet, consider what?
Haram.
And the Muslim should not use it and should not consume it. Like, example of such birds are eagles, falcons, hawks. The prohibition of eating such kinds of birds is illustrated in the hadith narrated by Ibn Abbas. Now, as we said before about animals, the Shaykh is giving you what? Also what? The dalil, the proof that this is not my word, but this is the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who said, right, he said, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prohibited eating any of the fan beasts of prey or any of the birds having talons. Right? All these types of birds are not allowed. Right. Let's go to move to the
Amar. Of course, regarding the hunting.
Yes.
If you use shotgun.
Yes.
For the birds.
Yes.
Is it halal to eat or what?
Yes, if you see, if you are sorted to.
Yes.
To consume it, to eat it, it's okay.
So you have to also say Bismillah?
It's okay, so you just make the takbir, yes. Just send me, say Bismillah. Okay. Among the birds that are prohibited, forbidden to be eating, are those which feed on carrion. What does it mean, carrion? Carrion. Animal, birds and carrion, like vultures and crows. What mean carrion here? Means dead, okay, or waste, dead animals or waste. You know crows? Crow. What they come? They come to what?
To eat
the dead animal which was left. You found a cat that was hit by a car a few days ago. And then there come the crows too. This is why they call crows, they call it the cleaner of the environment. You know, they give them this. they give them this honor. They say they are the cleaner of the environment. Because they clean, they eat all these dead body of other animals, other birds. Also, this should not be eaten. So this is also haram to be eaten. Now, طيب, owing to the evil food they feed. This is the reason here. They are different brothers, but because the food they consume also is not good, bad, evil, therefore the Muslim should not use it. طيب, it is also prohibited to eat the animals that are considered foul, such as snakes, rats and insects. These discussing, you know, things to eat. You know, some countries, maybe you are surprised to say, especially we are here in this area or in Africa, the people they may not use or eat. I don't know about Africa there. Maybe brothers they can tell us. But in the Far East, subhanAllah, you know this, the Far East, like China, you know, Korea, all these, subhanAllah, they eat all everything.
In the Philippines,
almost everything they eat, you know, almost everything.
They eat the snakes, dogs.
Yeah, they eat snakes, dogs, insects, rats, whatever. You see, here we said in Islam, it is not lawful to eat these dirty things. See, because like snakes, like what rats, insects of all types, all these are haram, and Islam should not be eating. Ibn al-Qayyim, Ibn Taymiyyah rahmatullahi alayhi, said, listen to what Shaykh Ibn Taymiyyah said here. It is unanimously agreed upon among Muslim scholars that eating snakes and scorpions is prohibited. No differences among Muslim scholars. All of them, they agree about this. Prohibited. Therefore, if anyone eats such animal, regarding them as lawful to be eating, he is to be urged to repent. Urged to repent. Why? To repent because he committed sin by violating the teaching of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And whoever regards them as prohibited food but eats them is considered sinful and definitely disobedience to Allah azza wa jalla. Right. As mentioned above, it is prohibited to eat insects as they are injurious. The mosquito based depend on what? Blood. So you collect some of them and then you will make nice dish. SubhanAllah. Nobody will accept this. When we say nobody, for us, they, by the way, for our culture, for example. But for other people, they say, well, this is very, very delicious dish for them. Therefore, my dear brothers, always we say, when we talk about what is lawful and unlawful, we don't depend on our own taste. You can. Not because it looks for us good, then it's allowed or permissible. And because it looks bad, then we should not, I mean, consider haram. No. It's not for me or for you or for anybody to say about something that it is halal because he likes it, or say something about other things that it is haram just because he doesn't like. Sometimes you like something, but it is haram, therefore you don't use it. Al-Aziz, you catch your breakfast or whatever. Just kidding you. This is haram, man.
Yeah.
This is haram. How to eat it? It's okay to eat it. Okay. Then, some Muslim scholars are classified the land animals prohibited to be eating in six types. Now, look at this. Now, we give you general, you know, guideline for the lawful. The animal which is not allowed to be eating. Animals particularly stated in the Quran and Sunnah, such as the domestic donkeys. Right. Then, the first type, animals which was mentioned in very clear hadith or in ayah in the Quran that it is haram. Example for an animal which was prohibited in the Quran is what? The swine, the pork, right? The big?
Pork,
the
swine.
The pork. Right? Example that about animal mentioned in the Sunnah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is what? The domestic donkeys. This was mentioned in the hadith we mentioned before. Right. Second, animals restricted by certain characteristics and criteria like the fan, beasts of prey and the birds with talons. So these also classify or give you description for two types of, you know, animals and birds. The common character between the two, you know, types, I mean between these type of birds and animals is what? All of them, they depend on hunting and depend on eating meat or eating other animals or birds. Three, whatever feed and carrion like vultures and crows, as we mentioned. Anything which feeds on what? On something which is dirty, evil, unhealthy food, waste, all these things are harmful. Whatever is pernicious and injurious, like rats and snakes, also the same thing. Five, whatever is born as a result of compulsion between two animals, like what? Like that, you know, when the horse and the donkey, they meet, what's the outcome? The mule. You know the mule? Al-Baghil. Al-Baghil, a mule. The baby, their baby, that's come from the relation between the horse and donkey. This is the mule. The mule, it's not, you know, independent like race, like
horse,
you know.
Horse.
Huh?
Like horse to horse.
Yeah, like horse. We have horses. We have donkeys. But there's no mule. Where does this mule come from? Huh? Combination between horse and donkey. This also is not allowed based on what the Sheikh said here. Right. One of which is now to eat. Which is lawful to be eaten and the other is prohibited. One of which is lawful to be eaten and the other is prohibited. Like the mule. طيب, the Sheikh mentioned the reason in it. Why is it any outcome from two animals is haram? He said no. Look about the origin. The mule, for example, al-baghl, Arabic baghl they call it. طيب. والبغالة الله سبحانه وتعالى منشن in the Quran ها والبغالة والحمير اللي تركبوها right. So البغل the parents if you can say about this mule, one of them is lawful, the horse. The other one is what? Unlawful. The domestic donkeys is not lawful. The horse is lawful. So one of their parents is lawful and the other is unlawful. Therefore, it's not lawful to eat their baby, the mule. Clear? So this is about the mule. Right. Whatever the lawgiver of Sharia has ordered us to kill. Now, there are certain insects or animals, we were commanded to kill them, especially the five: rat, snake, scorpion, rabid dog, and the kite. All these are we were commanded to kill them. Like for example, if you see snake in your house or in your neighborhood, you should kill it.
So it's not prohibited to kill a rat.
No?
Rat.
Oh, someone. No, it is what we mentioned here.
Yeah.
It was mentioned. خمس فواسق that hadith. خمس فواسق يقتلن بالحل والحق. خمس فواسق five. Which should be killed even in Haram, even in Makkah. These are, again, the rat, snake, scorpion, rabid dog. What do you mean by rabid dog?
Wild
dog that attack people.
Yeah.
You know, not any dog, be careful, not any dog. But rabid, this dog that, you know, very aggressive. And some of the dogs, because of certain disease, you know, they become aggressive and they want to attack people. This, it must be what? Killed. It must be killed to send the people from there. Right. And that he, the Almighty has forbidden us from killing. There are certain things which we forbid not to kill, like hoopoe, the hoopoe, the hoopoe, huh? The hoopoe
and
the shrike. I don't know what it means, this one. Huh? Get the meaning. Okay. So these things are considered forbidden to be killed. So you have five that you should kill, and other you should not kill. And hudhud, the hudhud, you should not kill. Now, so these are the things. Maybe I can check this here, the meaning here.
Hippies. All words considered an evil.
So anything other than these, you know, outside this classification, will you consider what? Halal and love. So now we already classify all these 6 points, 6 criteria. So any animal is not among these, then will be what considered as halal, and you can eat it. Like for example, horses, like chicken, like goats, cows, wild donkey, they call it zebra. This zebra is allowed also. Rabbits also is allowed. And all of whatever is considered as good, yes. Now.
Zebra, the wild zebra they are eating?
Yeah, it's okay.
It's halal?
It is halal, yes. Mm. It is halal. It's like the horse.
Look at this mention.
Yeah.
You mean the horse also they eat?
Yeah, the horse is allowed.
And donkey?
Yeah, okay. Donkey, not domestic.
Domestic
donkey, no. Wild donkey, like zebra, is okay. Got my point?
Yeah.
Because before, it was even domestic donkey, it was allowed and halal. Then because people, they consume it, so almost run away. So people, they will not find donkeys to use for their moving.
Okay.
So the Prophet ﷺ said, forbidden them, said, don't eat them. Okay? And you know, people in the villages, in farms, they depend on donkeys. So this is the purpose, this is the wisdom here. But any animal, any dog which is in the wildness, like the zebra, it's allowed to be eaten. No problem.
But they say according to the leg, it is different. Yeah?
What?
The leg of the donkey.
Yes.
They say that before that he...
No, it's not. Whenever, you know, since Allah has created the donkey, it is the same donkey. You see, this is just people explanation. Okay, even explanation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here, this is one of the reason that people or ulama explain. And Allah alam, maybe there's other reason, as you said, we need to check this.
Look, sister, it's domestic.
It's okay, no problem.
It's a domestic.
Does it? Now this, does it depend on eating meat? Does it eat meat?
No. Only grass.
It's okay, no problem.
Doc, excuse me about the frog. It's very frog.
Frog is not good. Pardon is not good because it depends on eating insects, right?
Yes, yes.
So this is why it is bad, because the feeding is evil.
Okay.
You see, what are the criteria?
Okay.
There are sometimes, look, sometimes the cow is forbidden. Sometimes the cow is forbidden. I said, how come? How come the cow forbidden, right? You eat cows, right?
Yes.
Beef. Sometimes it's forbidden. So when it is forbidden?
Indoor.
Huh? How can you tell me?
Because it's also a domestic cow.
No.
Indoor.
Huh?
Cow is forbidden.
I'll tell you now. Sometimes it's forbidden.
If they give some milk.
You see, sometimes the cows and some domestic animals, they eat from the waste of other animals. Like sometimes, you know, there's no food, and the cows were locked in a place where they were not given food. So they try to find grass or something to eat from the waste of other animals. This is called the jallala. Place, this place, that place, even prayer is not allowed. Okay? So any animals which depend on this, was not eating good food, is what? Forbidden. Even it was, you know, originally it was halal. The jallala, called the jallala of cows and camels, are excluded from the meal of lawful food. Right. Imam Ahmad ibn Dawood and other compiler of the hadith have related that the Prophet that Umar radiallahu anhu said, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam forbid eating jallala or drinking its meat. Even drinking the meat of this animal, the cow, was dependent on something which is not good for their feeding, then also it's not lawful. And easy to see the mercy of Allah Azza wa Jal, because such meat or milk, if it was consumed by a human being, it will endanger his health. His health, because whatever the animal eats will be in the meat, right? Or in the milk. So if somebody come and drink it or eat it, then he will be affected by this. Right. Also, it is also related on the authority of Umar ibn Sa'id that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam forbade eating the meat of domestic donkeys and forbade riding jallala or eating its meat. Jallala, as we mentioned, what? The animal which depends on what? Huh? On eating or getting its food from the waste of other animals. It doesn't make any difference whether the jallala is from the animals of grazing, livestock, poultry, or other animals. Moreover, its milk and egg are also considered impure until the animal is detained from 3 days. So if you have, for example, chicken, or you have a cow, or you have a sheep, and it was locked and they're just eating this waste, you cannot eat them, you cannot take their meat, you cannot take their eggs. So what should you do? Kill them? No. Get them away from this, feed them good food for at least 3 days. This will clean their body from the waste that they consume. And then after this you can eat it and you can use it. Right. Muslim scholars have unanimously agreed that if the animal is fed of impure fodder, then detained and fed on pure food, its meat and milk become lawful. So after you feed it at least for 3 days with good food, clean food, then you can use it. Likewise, if plants and fruit are watered with impure water, then water with pure water. Be careful now. Some people, they may water their garden from the waste.
Bayara.
Huh? Bayara, this yellow white. You see which carry the bad water, the waste of houses. You see, it's not lawful to use them, to use this for to water vegetables or fruits. And if you know that this place was watered by this, then it's not lawful to eat from it. And the one who doing this, in fact, he's cheating other people. And it was found, some people, unfortunately, they go to some area where these cars come and drop their waste, and they, you know, they call it Bahirat al-Misk. A long time ago, there was very, very big lake, which was, you know, made out of the waste that all these, big cars drop over there. So some of people who they don't, you know, some maybe not Muslim or some ignorant, they grow some tomatoes or some fruits, and they may sell it to the people, which is haram. This is cheating, and this is against the law. But they were caught, I think, by the authority, and alhamdulillah, they stopped these practices. So the point here also at your home, don't say in a state of, you know, getting clean water, let the water come out from the toilet and then to this place, and then I can have some tomatoes or some fruits or some out of this. Don't worry, I will clean it, you know, clean it even with soap. Some people, this is their mind. But it's already, it was made, you know, it was fit and it was, you know, grow because of this dirty water. Therefore, it's not love. And just to show you the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah Azza wa Jalla forbade for us this wine for what? Huh? To protect our health. And the Muslim should be very, very wise. طيب. And they are deemed lawful. That's mean after watering them for 3 days at least or more with good water. Thus, they are no longer deemed impure food because they have been converted to good and lawful food by means of pure water. Right. Eating onions, is it good or is it lawful or not?
No. Yes.
No. Onions. Onions. Kenya.
Halal.
Is it onions? Is it halal or not?
It's halal, but during this time, like Friday.
MashaAllah, excellent. Yeah. Excellent. Yeah, this is the question here. So, these things which is not lawful to be eating in certain time. So eating onions, garlic, and chulai, such like foods with a bad smell is detestable, especially when attending mosques, as illustrated in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, whoever eats from this plant, that means garlic or onion, should not enter our mosque. Now some naive people, because he doesn't, maybe the kids sometimes they do this, he doesn't want to go to the masjid, so before the time of the prayer he eats onions. So when you still tell him, go to the masjid, he says, oh, but I already ate onions, how can I go? So he's just tricking himself. In fact, he's fooling himself. You see, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows about the intention, right or not? If you eat this onion not just to take it as an excuse, not to go to the masjid, you know, Allah Azza wa Jalla knows what's in your heart, what's in your mind.
But you can pray.
Huh?
You can pray.
Yeah, you can, but you know, as long as the problem here with the smell, If you can get out this smell away, and you can, it's okay, you can go. But here, and this is very important, my dear brothers, and subhanAllah, in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَخُذُوا زِينَتْكُمْ عِنْدَ كُلِّ مَسْجِدٍ. And the Prophet ﷺ also, one side of the zina, of the beauty of man, his not only his clothes, but also his smell. You know, just imagine him. You know, if you meet somebody with nice smell, you would like to check his hand, you want to, you know, stay longer to speak with them. But if you meet somebody who is stinky, what you will do? You just count the minutes to get away from his presence. Is it true or not?
Yes, yes.
Right. The Muslims should not bother others. Islam teaches us to be very, you know, very pure, very clean. So Muslim always should take good care of his body and his smell. This is why, my dear brothers, subhanAllah, the Muslim always clean. The Muslim always clean. Why? Because he take the hair, which is under, here, your arms, and private parts. This unneeded hair in the body, in fact, this is the place where this bacteria and bad smell comes from. And you can feel it now. If you are in line with some of non-Muslim, even he took shower, but he still stink. Sometimes, not all, you see. And also the Muslim should use perfume, especially when he go to a gathering. Go to a gathering. And this is why Jum'ah, Friday, Ghusl Jum'ah, the ulama said it is must, especially from the one who has some bad smell. So you should not hurt other people with this.
But doctor, there are some people who take shower in the morning, but they didn't change their clothes. That's why you must keep it.
Is
make it the same?
No, he should. If he clean, then he should clean his clothes.
They talk about, but they don't change
his clothes. No,
the same. Yes.
Then he'll tend to his dirt.
Yeah.
Right. Right. If anyone is compelled by necessity, now we come here to another rule. How about if something happened because of necessity? As we said before, every Muslim come across a situation, a matter of life or death. Can he violate these rules or not? To eat, for example, prohibited food other than poison food. Poison. Why? He said, the Sheikh said poison. Because the poison, you cannot use it to save your life. So the poison always is what?
Poison.
Poison. Haram. Don't say no because it's necessity, a matter of life and death. I found this bottle of poison. If you drink it, you will save your life. Or will take you faster to your end. So this is haram in all situations, poison. But for other food which is not kill the person, maybe hurt his body, but not, you know, to the point that killing him, then it is okay. So other than food, this he should perish. It is deemed lawful for him to eat only the amount that will support him and keep him alive. A person in the desert, he was almost dying because of hunger. He had no food. And on his way, he found a bird that was dead. Or animal who was dead. It was not poison, this animal. I mean, fresh, still. He can get something which is, he can eat it. It's okay. Even the animal is haram, but for this reason, to save his life, it's okay to take some. But to what extent? Only the amount they keep him alive till he get to place he can get food. Not eat everything. Na'am, and said it is halal. Same thing for a person who was sitting at a table for a place. And then he was almost dying because there's some food stuck in his throat. Somebody else when he saw him in this situation, he brought him a glass of wine. There's no water around, so he got wine to him. Is it allowed to take it or not?
Yeah,
so. Is it allowed to take just some to get this through away? But don't enjoy it and take the whole glass. And this is haram. If you get, alhamdulillah, and there's a lot of it, don't say, no, no, I have to complete this. So he take only the amount that he needs to get out of his problem. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, but whoever forced by necessity, neither desiring nor transgressing its limits, there is no sin open him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَمَنْ أُكْرِهَا, anyone who was forced by necessity to use forbidden food, then it is allowed because of this reason. طيب. Also, if anyone is compelled to eat from the food of others, provided that the owner of such food does not face the same circumstances of compulsion. Right? The former must be offered whatever may keep him alive in return for paying the price of the food. A person is hungry and there's no food. Then anybody should, who has food, should help him. Like if there's one man who has a food, enough food, and there's another man almost dying of hunger, can he can take from this food without the permission of the owner? It is not lawful because this is what stealing, right?
Mm-hmm.
Stealing. But if he now, in a case that he didn't eat, he would die. Then it's okay, but still he have to pay for this later on, or ask the permission of that person, because it was not because of his choice, but to keep his life and not destroying himself. The Shaykh Ibn al-Taymiyyah said, if the person in need of the food is poor, listen to this, then he does not have to pay compensation and retain for food, for feeding the hunger and clothing the naked as collective duty. And it becomes an individual duty. That means it is must. Why, my dear brothers? Because we were commanded always to save life. The Muslim command to save life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, whoever saved life as he saved the entire humanity. مَنْ أَحْيَاهَا فَكَأَنَّمَا أَحْيَى النَّاسَ جَمِيعًا. So this is my one of the noble purpose in Islam, that you save the life of others. It doesn't matter who is he, this other. Unless the warrior, if you are in war, fighting, نعم, with the enemies. But your neighbor, for example, is not a Muslim. Christian or Jew or any. And he was almost dying because he was full down, and he almost, you know, fell down from the mountain. Or there was blood running, and he will go with the water and die. And you are able to save him, then you have to save him. To save the life of others, because life is very, very sacred in Islam. Right. Moreover, if someone is compelled to use the property of others without consuming such property, like using clothes to protect the body from coldness, or robe or bucket to obtain water, or cooking pot, he must be giving such things at no cost. Person in need, person he is naked, and almost dying because of what?
Cold.
Of cold. And you have, mashallah, alhamdulillah, enough clothes. Then you should not come to him and say, will you buy this? And you have no money. It is must on you that you help him and give him to protect him from this Right. He must be giving such things at no cost, provided that the owner is not in need of them. Not in need of them. As we say, the person who have three jackets with him, how many jackets he will wear?
One.
One. And there's somebody who has nothing. Then he should give it to him. Either for some time and then he retain it, or he can give it to him forever if he has no way to get. Right? Anyway, we'll inshallah continue next week. Jazakumullah khair for your patience. And Sheikh Muhammad is not coming, so after 5 minutes break, we'll start talking something about Surah Al-Fatiha, inshallah.
Okay.
Jazakumullah khair.